Alright, we're going to do two different reverse De La Hiva leg drag transitions, and then a back take off of one of them as well. So the first De La Hiva, I want my hook strong and flexed, so it wraps around the top of her leg by her hip, and I should be able to push and pull with just this hook. And it frees up this leg to do a lot of different things, but kind of the basic position is just put the ball of your foot on their hip with the heel kind of pointed out, so you're safe from the stima locks. And I can use both my feet to push and pull and create space now. So for this transition, I'm going to put my arm in front of the shin like this, kind of curling my shoulder in, and this arm is just framing. When I'm looking to spin through, I'm going to extend my legs, do like a bicep curl on her shin, and my left arm's going to reach and pull myself through. So I'm going to push, my butt's going to come up in the air, and I'll pull and reach through. Like this. Reach for the back of the leg, and I just pull myself through to here. Now once I'm here, I want control of this leg. So when I keep pulling her foot with my elbow towards my head, my knee, the back of my knee is in the back of her knee, and that's clamping down. So I'm pulling, clamping, and this foot is hooking at the hip. Make sure your knee doesn't slide through. You're gonna get knee barred. So knee's safe, just hooking the hip. And so this kind of pulls her leg in three different directions, so I should be able to keep her leg here for as long as I choose to. So for the first move, I'm going to drop my left leg down first. The right leg's going to come down as well, and I'm going to bump back a little bit to pass my knee through. So bump back and back in. So I have like an upside down X guard almost. I'm going to swim my arm through, put her foot in my armpit, and this isn't going to last forever. Right? If she's quick, she can just jump her left foot out by putting all of her weight here. So I have to be kind of quick here. I'm going to kick and step and hug her waist. If she turns away from me, right, she does this, then I just come up and take her back. So what most people will do is they'll turn into you because they want to try to stay on top. So I'm going to use that against her. I'm going to load her up and just take her backwards. Here, landing in a leg drag. Foot still flexed behind the thigh. I'm going to close my knee on her hip to control the hip. Head pressure on the back of her shoulder so she's turned away from me. And I'm going to scoop her hips up also. So everything I'm doing, I'm trying to make it hard for her to turn into me. And then when she's stuck, turned into the mat, that's when I can switch and look for my back take. So again from this angle. So strong hook. Make sure we can push and pull. Other foot comes on the hip. Wrap the shin, so it'll extend, so we have space to work. Butt comes up, and we get to here. Clamp, kick, pull. Pulling the leg in three different directions. Then both my legs are gonna swing down and catch this one. So, one, two, bump back so my knee can pass through, and then pull myself back in. Swim under, give a little kick so their weight stays here, so it's hard for them to put their weight on their other leg to jump over. Hug the waist, and then just load them up. Take them backwards. Knee the mat, foot flexed behind their knee, and close your knee on their hip. And then we're putting head pressure and scooping up the hips so they can't turn into us. Then we come around the back, looking to take it. So that's just one option. Another option, you can take them the opposite direction, is same entry. So everything's the same here. Push, spin through. So now instead of going to this leg, we're going to go this one. So I'm going to lift up her leg, pass my foot behind the knee, grab onto the hips. In the gi, we'd be grabbing the belt. There's no gi, so holding the hips. I'm going to lift up and pass my left foot through to here. So top of the foot to top of the foot. Other foot in the knee, and I'm pulling her leg in two different directions. So I'm keeping myself attached and controlling her leg. And I'm just going to pull her into me, extend my legs up to the ceiling, and do the same thing, hug the waist. Now I'm going to take her over, and we're up in the same position on the other side. So same thing, close the knee, head behind the shoulder driving into them, foot flexed, and scooping up the hips so they can't turn into us. We come on the back.
So from this angle. Spin through. Lift up the foot. Pass our right leg behind the knee. Hug the hips. Left foot comes under, and our feet are both pulling opposite directions to hold the leg in place. We pull. Hug the waist, we're able to. And now when she starts falling, I'm going to pull my right leg out so I can get up. So she starts falling. Right leg comes out. So I can use it to get up. So right here. And then we scoop up the hips and drive in. Now the third option is kind of a cool back take off of this. So we do that same move. We kick, spin through. Everything's the same that we just did. But now I'm going to just shoot my legs straight up in the air. And as she falls, instead of hugging her waist, my right arm is going to catch her hip. So I'm going to make her fall, and I catch her hip, and my left arm grabs her thigh. I still have that X. Now I'm going to pull myself, my right thigh onto her stomach, to pass my hook through like this. And then you just kick to the mat, catch their arm, and catch their seatbelt when it opens. Spin through. Pass the foot, grab the hips. Other foot, pull. Now as she falls, I'm going to grab her hip and grab her thigh so I can pull myself in. Keeping this pressure here so I'm staying attached. I'm going to pull my right leg out and throw my right thigh onto her stomach. Here. Keeping that top of the foot to top of the foot. So I can push her leg, keep it bent, so it's easy to wrap my leg through and get here. Now I'm going to pull and kick the mat. So I'm going to throw her over to here and catch the arm, catch her seatbelt, and top hook comes in.